and on the Son, and on the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, good evening.
Good evening.
And praise the Lord.
And
happy welcome to the celebration of Lord's Common Mercy. Today, we celebrate the 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of their body. On this week, we celebrate the birthday of our dear Teresa Curry. Teresa, happy birthday! And on Wednesday, 16th, Elijah Curry. And anybody here? Joseph celebrate this week. On Monday, he's not here, okay. Happy birthday to you. Any more birthdays? Anybody anniversary? My dear friends, let's keep in our prayers our beloved Jim Adams, who is now suffering from stomach disease. So keep him in our prayers, Jim Adams. Let's pray for a moment. In today's Gospel, Peter asked to Jesus, if my brother sins against me, how often should I forgive? 7 times? Jesus said to him, not 7 times, but 77 times. Forgive unconditionally. Our merciful God forgives our trespasses unconditionally. So let's forgive and love unconditionally. Lord, we pray for our nation and all the nations' peace, unity, and prosperity. We pray for all our brothers and sisters, those who lost their dear ones on terrorist attack on Nairobi. We pray for all those who are sick and suffering. Let's offer our dreams, our prayers, our family, our dear ones, all our sorrows, sufferings, tensions, anxieties, temptations, and all our weaknesses into the hands of the Lord. Our emotions, laziness, pride, and all our evil thoughts, words, and deeds. Let's guard our mind, all our sins against the love of God and our neighbor. And so prepare to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous thought. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Thank you.
Let's pray. Look upon us, O merciful God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice, then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days, set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments, hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook false. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
the Romans, brothers and sisters. None of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
After they had been estranged for 16 years. She said, "My father was an alcoholic and had been since my childhood. Growing up with him had been a nightmare. My mother and my sisters, each of us, lived in fear of his drunken rages. Her mother finally divorced him for his drinking and abuse. Jill was married now, working at the University of San Francisco while earning a doctorate in psychology. What was he calling him about? Her father wanted to know if she felt like he loved her. No, I told him. That ended the telephone conversation. Later, when she was talking to her husband, he asked, "Do you think he'll try to get back in touch?" She said, "I don't know, and I don't care. What did he expect? That I would forget about the past and pretend that it didn't matter?" But when she found out that he had started in AA meetings in a sincere attempt to stop drinking and to get regular counseling, she said, "Everything that I had learned as a psychologist told me I couldn't bury my problems and expect them to disappear. Finally, after months of not hearing anything from him, her father called and asked if Jill would meet him for lunch. I was very nervous that first time we met. So they talked. His drinking had stopped. And he wasn't making excuses, he was simply discussing and laying out some of the disappointments in his life as they talked. The careers that went bad, the strain on his marriage, the eventual divorce. He poured out more and more about his life as a child, as a young adult, how his parents were so harsh on him and unloving. Now she could begin to see him in a whole new light. Jill's time together with her father began to increase. And when she had her two children, her father was there, and he was so delighted. She was opening up to him as he also opened up. Jill's story is all too familiar. It's very familiar to me because my dad was also an abusive alcoholic. More so to my younger brothers and sisters than to me. But being a child or a spouse of an alcoholic creates all sort of emotions, up and down, up and down. Fear, hate, guilt, as in, what did I do to cause this? Now, I'm not a psychologist. I don't understand why people do some of the things that they do. But I do understand that what Jill said about her studies as a psychologist, that you can't bury your problems, is true. And it's based exactly on what Jesus tells Peter in today's gospel about forgiveness. Unforgiveness and enmity towards others only hurt us. Could anyone nourish anger and expect healing from the Lord? We heard from Sirach. I knew that I had to forgive my dad. I knew it wasn't going to be easy. I eventually did, maybe a year before he died. Forgiveness does not mean that you suddenly erase everything in your brain that has happened to you. But it means that you deal with it. You let it go. And you grow. And you learn. And one of the biggest lessons that you can learn, hopefully, is that you don't want to fall into that same trap that your alcoholic parent fell into. And of absolute importance, and as part of AA, you must acknowledge the power of God in your life. As the song reminds us today, O my soul, forget not his benefits. He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills, redeems your life from destruction. The remedy for our difficulties in this life is not to run from them, nor to try to bury them. The remedy is our merciful, loving, and forgiving God. All God's people said,
Amen.
I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten, not made,
consubstantial with the Father, through him upon his name,
for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the righteous. I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church.
Let's pray. In today's second reading, St. Paul reminds us, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. Our Heavenly Father is ever-loving, forgiving, and compassionate Father. Let's gather all our needs and prayers into the hands of the Lord.
In today's gospel reading, Jesus reminds us that if we are to gain forgiveness from our Heavenly Father, we in turn must practice forgiveness in our daily lives. We pray for the grace to forgive those who may have offended us, or to banish resentment, anger, and hatred from our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Pope Francis and Bishop Stephen be filled with the Holy Spirit and wisdom, that they can teach and serve with truth and humility,
and for the leaders of nations, that they may serve with wisdom, compassion, and humility all the people in their care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick, both at home and in the hospital, that our loving and caring Father look down on them with compassion and give them relief in their illness. We pray especially for those with the COVID-19 and those names that are listed in our church bulletin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask you, Lord, to protect and watch over our families, especially the Shelton and Batia family, Ellis and Dial family, Teresa Curry and Sister Jensen, to whom these masses are offered this week, so that in the strength of your grace, all their members may enjoy prosperity, possess the priceless gift of your peace and joy, and bear witness in this world to your glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have recently lost loved ones and ask the Lord to comfort them with assurance that those who have departed this life, especially Gail Martin, Joe Martins, Roland Gaddy Sr., Pauline Hurd, and Sister Verona Paul, are now in the company of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers.
God, the Father of mercies and forgiveness, bless our nation, all the nations, and all our brothers and sisters, those who are attending this holy mass. Bless all their prayers and personal intentions. Bless our parish family, all families, all parents, all children, and all spouses. Lord, bless us to pray and give us the strength and courage to pray. Lord, forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for whose goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth, and on hands it will become for us bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, and from hence it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
pray my brothers and sisters that my sacrifice and words may be accepted with God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
Let's pray. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and by your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty of salvation, always in the river, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being, and why in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the blood of life eternal. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this along and eat up, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice, my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you are worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Come here to die, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and with the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, our bishops, all the clergy, and all the people. Remember your servant, Gail Marin, whom you have called from this world of devotion. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and our prayer mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, or we pray. That Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who praise you throughout the ages, we may merit to be praised life, and may praise and glorify the Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, our Almighty Father, lead the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
before the Lamb of God, before the King who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those who are supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
sure to take up a broader one where a couple of important things. U.S. National Prayer Day and Fasting will be held here on September the 24th, 2020. Father Thomas is switching the Mass and the Holy Hour and the Rosary from Wednesday to September the 23rd to Thursday, September the 24th, in observance of that National Prayer and Fasting Day. So, expect a big crowd to be there for that. And this year, PSR will start an offline virtually, on Sunday, September the 13th. Randy will have a sign-up sheet in the vestibule for parents. If you have any questions, please contact Randy. And we're starting our adult religious education class for 2020 and 2021 of the RCIA, as we call it. We'll begin with an inquiry session for anyone interested in being baptized and or being admitted into full participation in the Catholic Church. Please come join us on Sunday, October the 4th, after Mass, after the Sunday Mass, in Basic Hall. And for more information, you can contact me. My love is right there. Thank you.
Let's pray together. Our sacrament must be holy.
Our sacrament is divine. Our operation of God changes with every moment of time. We believe that Jesus Christ is really, truly, and substantially present in the Holy Communion. Body, blood, soul, and divinity. Our sacrament was the body, our sacrament is divine. Our operation of God changes with every moment of time.
My dear brothers and sisters, thank you, Dick and Abby, for a wonderful family and serving the altar. Thank you, Mary and Will, and thank you, Steve, Eddie, and John, and Pew Choir Barbara. And thank you, Nick Martin, for being rector of the day. Thank you, Job and Jim. And thank you, all of you, for being together for this holiness. God bless you. Have a great week to your heart. Let's pray. May the working of this heavenly gift honor be free, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Amen. Amen.